Hello. Another new Lego set unveiled recently. This one's just called Modern Art. It is Modern Art, the Lego set. There's only one. $50 US, 50 euros, 45 pounds UK. It says coming soon on date. Oops. I think it's supposed to be August 1st. Oh, it's 65 Canadian dollars, which equates to 49 US dollars. And this comes with 805 pieces. Now, are they getting ahead of themselves calling this modern art? And when it's mostly abstract and abstract impressionist only? Whatever. It's just a name. You know that I don't look at price to part ratio as being the end all be all for value in all things in the universe. It's not me, I don't do that. Because it doesn't make sense if you think about it. But you can still look at it as a number and, you know, get some kind of impression from it. I think that the value here is fine. Because with each of these things, there are leftover parts that they're not really showing you. You're not really seeing how much is left over here. And ultimately, it's just a parts pack. This doesn't even need to be marketed as an 18 plus set. It really doesn't. It's just a parts pack of colorful pieces. Use them however you want. If you don't like what you see here, that's fine. It's still just a parts pack. Make something different with it if you want to, you know. I've already seen some significant hate for this set out there. I don't think that's warranted at all. You know, you kind of get folks on both sides of this or both ends of the spectrum. They just hate it, think it looks terrible, or who think it's amazing because it's art. And when I look at it, I see it. I feel it. That makes me intellectually superior to everyone who doesn't like it or doesn't get it. No, it does not. It's the whole, one of the major points of art. Not everybody's going to like it. It's going to make different people feel different ways, and it's going to impress upon them in different ways. Might impress upon the same person in a different way at two different times, you know? It's interesting that they just really limited their examples. You know, this is abstract impressionist. This is abstract impressionist. That's a person. I probably have a scarf on. I want to say skiing, or it says wheels, so probably cross country. Wheeled board. I feel like this is maybe this is slalom here or something. And then with the checkerboard, I'm assuming this is like start finish line, something like that. Something about active moving sport activity. This is just purely abstract. Now this is a person, so there's eye, cheek, rouge, mouth, ear or earring, bow in the hair, person is crying, lying down, and just see what this is supposed to represent. That's the hanger right there, one of the hangers. So that's good that I'm assuming they include two of those pieces in the set. It's strange that they would actually show it, not hide it, in one of these hero pictures, the main ones. It's a butterfly! Look, the wings! Wing, body. So this is a butterfly coming to tell this person who is sad that it's okay, there's still good things in life. There's still beauty in life. You know? Well, that has the hanger shown as well. That's odd. Strange. Weird. And this is a big version of the butterfly. Look at that. This gives you just a little bit of an impression of just how many extra pieces are included in the set that we're not seeing. So I think the value is fine. Caution against hating it too deeply or loving it too deeply. It's just a parts pack, you know? If you think it's great, wonderful. If you don't, that's okay. And yeah, don't hate on folks for having the opposite impression of you know how it hits you. I think both ways, both sides are equally valid, but ultimately it's just a bunch of pieces of plastic in a box. coming out on August 1st. And I don't mind it. Those are my thoughts. Bye for now.